So, it's time. Are you ready?
Actually, not yet. I'll come back in a bit.
I see. I'll wait here, then. Aloy. Let us speak, Aloy. Are you ready?
Yes, I guess. It's louder than I expected.
You've never been so close before.
I guess everything's bigger up close.
Soon it'll all seem familiar. Like home.
I don't know about that.
Look for High Matriarch Tirsa. She'll help you. Any other concerns?
Any final lessons before I head in?
No. You've learned every lesson the Wilds have to teach.
It was you who taught me, not the Wilds. Not sure my bow and spear will be much help in there, though.
It is with bow and spear that you'll win what you've wanted all these years, Aloy. Answers.
What should I expect once I'm inside?
There'll be people celebrating and feasting. More than you've ever seen in one place. No other village compares to Mother's Heart. It is the seat of the High Matriarchs, a center of Nora life, a jewel of the sacred land. Give it time, and you'll grow fond of it. As I was, back when I was at the tribe.
Are you sure they're gonna let me in?
I've told you, Aloy. By law, any child outcast can run in the proving.
And any who pass are made braves and are outcasts no more. I know that. But not everyone follows the law like you do, Rost.
Have faith, Aloy. The tribe will honor your right.
I'm ready to do this. See you back home in a few days?
You will not find me there, Aloy. Here. Take this to remember.
Why are you talking like we'll never see each other again? No. No!
You should be with the tribe. And I will always be an outcast.
But I told you, I have that figured out. I'll come to you in secret. I'll be the one breaking the law, not you. You don't even have to talk to me.
This attachment to me will only hold you back. It's my wish that you embrace the tribe. You've lived in isolation long enough.
Not until now, I didn't.
For your sake, I must go where you will never find me. This is goodbye.
Fine. Better for me, actually, to not have to waste any more time on you.
I hope one day you will understand.
See? It's easy throwing away worthless things, isn't it?
I've disappointed you. I hope you'll forgive me someday.
How could you do this to me? On today of all days? I can't think about it. Not now. I have to keep my mind on the proving.
You will turn back outcast. Or bleed. Your choice.
Make way! Make way! Braves, stand aside. She is welcome here. Mother's heart is open to you, child. Come. I assure you, most Nora aren't so rude as those idiots.
You're Tirsa?
Who else would I be? Come on now. I've been waiting for this day a long time.
You have?
Oh, yes. But for the moment, I must leave you. I have other outsiders to keep safe tonight.
You what?
Envoys from another tribe, the Karja. Come to observe the proving, and oh, how the Nora hate the Karja.
Karja?
But that's my problem. We will talk later. In the meantime, enjoy the festival. Oh, down the path to the right, you'll find an old friend who can't wait to see you.
But I don't know anyone here.
Try telling him that. We will talk later. May the goddess protect.
What is going on?
Someone else. Aloy! It's you, isn't it? Over here.
Too drunk to dance?
It is Aloy, isn't it? I'm remembering your name correctly?
Are you the old friend Tirsa told me about? I don't know you.
I see you don't recognize me. Well, it was a long time ago. Teb is my name. You were half my size when you saved me from a herd of machines.
I remember. You tried to thank me.
I never forgot that day. All these years, I hoped to see you again, if you came to run in the proving. As you can see, I didn't turn out to be much of a hunter. I serve the tribe as a stitcher instead, a maker of garments and armor. In preparation for this day, I've made an outfit for you. I hope you like it.
What's it going to cost?
Cost? Nothing. Consider it the thanks I tried to give years ago. Long overdue. Seems to fit you perfectly.
Thank you, Teb. I've never had anything like this before.
Well, it's yours. I think you'll find it affords more protection than what you were wearing. Every outfit offers some advantage. It's always a trade-off. Anyway, I shouldn't keep you any longer. Head for the Matriarch's Lodge if you want to find Tirsa. You'll know it when you see it. A large wooden building with an angry mob waiting outside?
Tirsa said something about envoys from another tribe?
Yes, that's what the mob's angry about. Karja visiting our sacred land for the first time in years. I'd expect to see some tomatoes fly, maybe rocks. Hopefully not spears. In any case, be ready to duck.
Nice.
dance and not enough fist fights this year. Whatever happens, I know I'll rest beside my mother and my friends.
Jog! Get down from there! Bad enough you're drunk. Why do you have to go climbing houses?
My mother's
what an idiot he is. Every year this happens, every year. At least he's not trying to run a brave trail. Please, not now. The sacred land is my home. I never want to leave it.
Listen carefully now.
Get down from
well,
there!
You'll have to
now.
Tell us when I'm
oh,
gone.
Oh, that's just what you want, isn't it? For me to fall on my head!
All life came from All Mother. People, machines, and beasts.
Huh. Nice.
All were her children.
Everyone knows
they lived alongside each other in the comfort of her wild embrace. But some were restless. Though they took of her bounty, they wanted more. These.
Aloy, over here.
Karst? What are you doing here?
Careful. Pretend like we've never met. I wasn't supposed to trade with outcasts in the wilds, remember?
How could I forget? And how generous of you to talk to me now.
Don't be like that. You know I'll be rooting for you in the proving tomorrow. Can't wait to see the looks on some of these faces when you win. And if you need any last-minute supplies, I'm your man.
So, Mother's Heart. I thought you preferred the wilds.
Well, man can't drink alone all the time, can he? Truth is, I get lonely once in a while. There, I admitted it. Don't think less of me.
I won't hold it against you, if you give me a discount.
You can't be.
I'm joking, Karst. It's good to see you.
Don't go soft on me. I'll give you my best prices, I promise.
Right then, time to go.
Good luck tomorrow, Aloy.
In a moment, we shall bless the proving. But first, we have guests to welcome.
For 2 years, we have been at peace with Akarja. It is time to restore our bonds of trade with Meridian. These envoys come to us under a banner of peace.
Peace. It's peace.
An annunciation of gratitude written
killers
by the
and slavers!
Hand of yeah, Sun King man. Of
killers
our...
and slavers!
Hey,
Luminance
hold of your fruit, Nora. Nora Faithful, hold your fruit. Now I'm Azaram, not Karja. So I'll put it to you straight. The 13th Sun King was a murderous bung. He was.
He's a tyrant and a monster. Raided my tribe for blood sacrifice, just like yours. My own sister was taken. I hated the Karja. But the 13th King is dead. 2 years now. And who killed him? The 14th. Not because he lusted for power, but because someone had to put an end to his father's atrocities.
Yeah! Yeah!
The message that this poor priest means to read is an apology. Straight from the lips of the 14th king. So please, can't you lend him your ears?
Thank you. An annunciation of gratitude written by the hand of Sun King Avad, 14th Luminance of the Radiant Line.
He was of the Nora. Sister,
on the eve of your proving, no, the Karja
I won't let the Karja faithless stop me from enjoying the festival. What harm can they do now?
Focus, just like mine.
I won't let the Karja faithless stop me from enjoying the festival. What harm can
they
do?
Where did he find his focus? You're the only other person I've ever seen wearing a focus. Where did you get yours?
What? A Nora? Wearing one of these? That's impossible. Your tribe fears the old places, forbids them.
Who says I'm like other Nora?
Why, I guess you're not. If you've gone delving in the ruins of the metal world.
What's wrong?
Apologies. Malfunction.
Olin, you making friends with locals, are we?
I'll come back.
Wait.
No. We'll talk later. Have to go.
Whoa. Well, I guess he's more hungover than I thought. Hey. You got the same trinket that Olin has on his head. Since when did those become fashionable?
His name is Olin? Who is he? And where did he get one of these?
He's just a scrounger with friends in high places. He spends half his time digging for artifacts, the other half drinking or dicing. As for the trinket, well, I guess he dug it up somewhere. Just a weird old jewel he sticks on his face. I mean, no offense. It looks great on you.
I thought your friend was gonna go down in a hail of fruit, but you really calmed the crowd.
Thanks. I wasn't sure I could do it. The Nora is still pissed with the Karja about the Red Raids, and who can blame them?
I wanted to ask you something else.
If you want. But I'll also be around after that blessing thing, if that'd be a better time to talk.
I never heard anything about Red Raids growing up. What were those?
Your tribe was at war and you didn't even know? Were you kept hidden away? Did you have overprotective parents or something?
I grew up as an outcast, shunned by the tribe.
Oh, yeah, I've heard the Nora do that. That seems cruel, if you ask me. But even an outcast knows about the derangement of the machines, right? How they get deadlier every year? Well, the mad Sun King figured if he spilled enough blood to the Sun God, it would calm the machines. Didn't work. But for years, he raided the tribes and took captives for sacrifice. My sister among them. The Nora put up a good fight, but lives were lost.
So what happened? How did it all end?
The Mad King's own son united Karja rebels with Oseram freebooters. And together we did the impossible, took back Meridian and killed the crazy old king. So now the Sun sits on the throne, and it's a big improvement. Under Avad, there's no more sacrifices, no more slavery. People from all tribes are welcome in Meridian now, even Nora exiles. You really should come visit.
Who are the Oseram?
Oh, that's my tribe, far to the northwest. We're good at three things: arguing, working steel, and brewing.
And freebooters. What are those?
I guess you could say we were mercenaries, warriors for pay. Except a lot more loyal than that makes us sound. Avad couldn't have taken down his father without our metal and muscle. And now, some of us serve proudly as his personal vanguard.
Your sister was taken captive and sacrificed. That's terrible.
Captive, yes. Sacrificed, no. It takes more than a few Karja to finish Ursa. She got away, and now she's my captain. Captain of the entire vanguard, favored by the Sun King himself.
How did she survive?
Oh, that's a story, all right, but it takes a while to tell. Maybe another time over a drink or three? Or just come to Meridian and meet her yourself. I think you'd like each other. You're both rather, direct.
You said the machines have been getting more dangerous every year.
Yeah. I don't have to tell you that, right?
First I've heard of it.
Oh. Sorry. I just assumed everyone knew. Well, the way I hear it, 15, 20 years ago, the machines weren't always pissed off like they are now. When a hunter came at them, they'd spook and run. So it was hard to take them down, but not dangerous, so long as he was smart enough to jump out of the way. But then the derangement starts up and everything changes. Now, when a hunter fires a shot, the machines snarl and charge right at him. A few more years pass, and they start attacking people on sight. Going anywhere becomes a major risk. And if that wasn't bad enough, entirely new kinds of machines start showing up. Bigger, meaner, and heavily armed.
Like the Sawtooth?
Yeah, 10 years ago, that one. But every couple of years or so, something worse comes along. Believe me.
So what's making it happen?
And no one knows. And the machines, well, they aren't telling.
Tell me about the derangement again.
Well, the way I hear it, 15, 20 years ago, the machines weren't always pissed off like they are now. When a hunter came at them, so it was hard to take them down, but then the derangement. Now, when a hunter fires, a few more years pass. If that wasn't bad enough, entirely new kind.
Like the Sawtooth?
Yeah, 10 years.
So what's making it happen?
No one knows.
If the Karja have such a cruel history, how did you end up serving them?
The last king and his men were butchers. But the new king wants peace. There's nothing cruel about that. Besides, the Karja don't just fight, they build. Well, take Meridian. Next to it, everything else is just a bunch of sticks and stones.
Just how big is Meridian? What's it like?
Where do I even start? My tribesmen are masters of the forge, the best tinkers in the world. But when it comes to building, the Karja have us beat. The city soars over a canyon with more bridges than the Nora have roads and buildings tall as mountains. And across the valley stands the spire, like a blade thrust into the sky reflecting the sun. You really owe it yourself to see it. So consider that a challenge. Or an invitation.
I want to ask you about something you said before.
Ask away.
I've never seen armor like yours before.
You've never seen Vanguard steel? Well, let me introduce you. Ring-locked, impact-protected, sturdy enough to choke a Sawtooth. It has to be. The Vanguard are the Sun King's best. Life-takers and machine-breakers to a one. It might even give a Nora warmaid like you more trouble than she can handle.
With all that metal to slow you down? I doubt it.
Yeah, hard to say. From where I'm standing, looks like a pretty even match.
What else do you know about Olin?
Is he really that interesting? I'm starting to get jealous. Well, he scours the wilds for ruins, digs up stuff, and sells it to nobles. When he's not scrounging, he's scouting. Exactly the skills you want the man guiding your expedition to have. I've known him for a few years. He's a loyal companion, cares for his family, holds his drink well enough. I like him, but besides that, not much to tell.
Tell me about Olin again.
When he's not scrounging, I've known him.
I should make my way to the blessing.
Yeah. Look, maybe I shouldn't say this, but it's obvious that you don't belong in this backwater. I mean, you're smart. You're obviously capable, and... Well, I mean, look at you.
What are you talking about?
You know what. All right, if you ever visit Meridian, look me up. I'll show you around, make introductions. It'd be a whole new life, if you want it. Anyway, I have to go to that blessing thing, too. So, see you around, maybe?
Looks like a strong field for the proving year. It's in all Mother's hands, who knows, after all.
High Matriarch Tears has gone too far this time. In my babies, we want to close to charge in other lanes. I wish some people knew their place.
You have a blessing to attend? Let's talk later. Can't get enough, huh? Not surprised. But we should talk later. Let's talk later. Don't you have a blessing to attend? Let's talk later.
We'll start the blessing when all aspirants are in place.
Oh!
Expecting more tomatoes?
In truth, I thought they were throwing stones.
Stones hit a lot harder. You'd know the difference.
If you wish to speak, we should do so after the ceremony. I'd rather not hold things up, or do anything else that angers these people. So many spears. Spears everywhere. After the ceremony, please. Better to talk then. Let us talk after the ceremony. So many spears. Spears everywhere. After the ceremony, please. Better to talk then.
Aloy, take your place right there. The prayer lantern is yours. I made it for you.
Blasphemy.
Sisters.
Aspirants, before each of you sits a prayer lantern crafted by your mother. In her honor, light its flame.
This is for me. For all I did to make it here. And the answers I'll get after I win the proving.
All Mother, hear our prayer! What is the child but a mother's hope that takes flight? A glowing flame that climbs the air, set free to the wind, sailing the sky till it fades and falls. So, from one to another, passes the chain of love.
There's Olin. I have some questions for him.
The Karja took my little sister and their aid 5 years ago. All Mother, I sure.
Your blessing was most illuminating. I've never seen its like. A rare gift, indeed.
But you don't believe in All Mother, do you?
Usually the distance between our tribes shrouds Nora ways from Karja eyes. But here among you, I see a beauty that shines true. Perhaps Naman is right after all, that the sun's light brightens all lands and all peoples.
Who's Naman?
One of my brethren, who believes the sky is wide enough for the faiths of all tribes.
Who is the Sun King you speak for?
His luminance Avad is the 14th king of the Radiant Line. His light envelops the sky and everything beneath it. He is the chosen of the sun. By his divine rule, we are given sight and purpose.
You speak highly of him. Do you know him well?
By his nature, he is unknowable and infallible. We are his instruments, not his companions. I have been in his presence, but we draw down our hoods so as not to behold his light directly.
He's the sun, he has total power, and no friends. That couldn't go wrong.
If your sun kings are so infallible, how do you explain the crimes of the last king?
Well, the sun's glory is a great and brazen crown for a vessel as small as a man. If the vessel is flawed, indeed, in the burial caves, one can see the skulls of the past kings are cracked, trialed, and fired in the sun's kiln. That can be too much for any man to bear, even a ruler of men.
So the sun can make bad choices like anyone else?
Oh, no, no, no.
Has there ever been a sun queen?
Many wives and consorts, of course.
all... Oh, you mean for the sun to choose a queen? This has not happened.
Why not?
The sun is masculine, of course, and so would choose its heirs thus.
It's a light in the sky. I've never seen anything dangling from it. I don't know if you've noticed, but women run things around here.
Well, Avad took a woman as captain of his vanguard, the first to hold such an honor.
You mean Aaron's sister, Ursa. From what he told me, she sounds formidable.
Oh, formidable indeed. A woman, and an outsider as well.
She might make a fine Sun Queen, given a chance.
A Sun Queen? Oh, no, no, no. No.
Who are you, Sun Priest?
I am the Reverend Irid. The glory of the Karja is the sun's glory, reflected. We sun priests are but glimmers of its great light.
You just said a lot, but you didn't tell me anything.
My apologies. My duty is to carry out the will of the sun by serving its emissary among us, the Sun King. I comfort those who walk by the light of day, and I travel to those in far reaches whom the light barely touches, bearing warmth.
So you live in Meridian?
I do. Where better to mark the sun's divine passage than where the sandstone glows in the light of its passing? I was raised in the Mesa's great shade, its wild bird markets and metal cellars, spices and colored silks.
Sounds impressive.
Oh, you should behold it. And you can if you make the journey. At His Luminance's order, we have flung its gates open to all.
Any Nora who leaves the sacred land becomes an exile. But hey, who knows where I'll end up. Did you come all this way just to deliver your Sun King's speech?
It is my duty, and also my honor, to carry the light of atonement to those we overshadowed and wronged. I swallowed my fear, but it reemerged. I am glad Erend Van Guardsman made this journey. He is my shield, a good man.
Why were the Karja at war with the Nora?
Under the 13th Sun King, the Karja had no peace with any tribe. His Luminance has sent those days to dusk. We must renew the light that binds us, though few volunteered to come here.
The Nora scare you. They're good at making people feel unwelcome.
It's said one soldier died for every Nora taken alive. But I see you can be as calm as you are fierce.
This has been illuminating, but I should get going.
You have already been blessed, but may the dawn find you, the day warm you, and the dusk have light to guide your path.
Of course Bast is going to win. Just look at him.
I shall ask the dawn for your success.
Is it just me?
I shall ask the dawn.
Hello, Olin.
You know my name. Ah, guess Aaron told you.
Why did you act so strange when we spoke earlier?
Must be this festival. I'm really not one for crowds. Maybe I should just turn in.
Stop dodging my questions.
All right, cool your fire. I got nothing to hide.
I've never seen anyone else with a focus. Where exactly did you find it?
In a ruin, north of the claim. That's our name for the Aseram homeland. Up there, the metal seams run deep. Steel giants half buried in loose soil. Forgotten caves that the old ones bored into mountain rock. Your eyes just lit up.
I found my focus in a cave just like you're describing. A ruin of the old ones.
If you've delved yourself, you know as much as I do. Go to those places for answers. Not me.
When we spoke earlier, you winced, then looked like you were in pain. Or frightened. Did your focus show you something?
It didn't show me anything. I told you. It malfunctioned. Happens all the time.
You're not a very convincing liar.
Do you always accuse people you've just met of lying?
Only the ones who aren't telling the truth.
Fire and spit, girl! I'm a plain hammered man with nothing to hide. You don't believe me, that's your trouble, not mine.
What are you doing here, Olin? Why come to Noraland?
Eren needed a scout for his expedition, and a second for his drinking, that's all. Someone to stop the Sun Priest getting lost. When all this is over, I'm back to delving ruins, rummaging for scrap, scrounging up trinkets to sell.
So you're an explorer?
Just another outlander, girl. A man's gotta make his shards. I just make mine in service to the King's court, that's all.
I don't understand. We have this device in common, but you can't wait to stop talking to me.
I already have all the friends I need, girl. I don't need the bother.
I'm used to being shunned by the tribe. I thought you'd be different.
It's nothing personal. It really isn't. You should try to enjoy yourself tonight. Big day tomorrow. Always best to make every day count.
Eh? Oh, it's you. Go away. I'm not...
Find fortune in your trials, Aloy. Find fortune in your trials, Aloy.
She's going to win.
I'm preoccupied. My brother is ill.
Find your bed, outcast, and dream of winning the proving. That's the closest you're gonna get.
Oh, this is the bedhouse? With you standing guard, I figured it was the latrine.
Your very presence here!
Well, well. Look who's come in from the wild. The motherless outcast. I see you've still got a scar from where that rock I threw hit you. Now that's a cherished memory.
You can be a real lard sometimes, boss. Cut it out.
You didn't know the words to the blessing, did you? But no one hears your prayers anyway.
She looks serious.
We saw you talking with the outsiders. Couldn't convince them to take you either, huh?
Wouldn't want to cross her.
Where's your bite, outcast? Or did you need my permission to speak in the presence of a true Nora?
She looks serious. I pray to All-Mother every day. Do you too?
You didn't know the words to the blessing, did you? But no one hears your prayers anyway.
I'm here.
Where's your bite, outcast?
Leave me alone.
Or did you need my permission to speak in the presence of a true Nora?
It's late, and I've got nothing to say to you. Take it up with Bost if you've got a problem. It's late, and I've got nothing to say to you.
We saw you talking with the outsiders. Couldn't convince them to take you either, huh? Aw, you even try to dress like a real Nora. Not that it fools anyone.
So this is how it's gonna be with you, is it?
This is how it's gonna be with everyone, outcast. You belong in the wilds, not Mother's heart. And you definitely don't belong in the proving.
Too bad for you that I'm gonna win it then.
I've trained all my life for this. If I lost to you, I'd make myself an outcast for life.
Don't overestimate yourself. You wouldn't last long in the wilds.
You know, I often think of the day I gave you that scar. It's a cherished memory.
You should cherish it. If Rost hadn't shot my stone from the air, you'd be missing an eye. But I suppose you leave that part of the story out when you tell it, don't you?
I branded you that day to mark your shame.
All you did that day was make me stronger. Just wait. I'll show you tomorrow.
Yeah, right. This is boring. Time for Boss to get some sleep. You'll be the one surprised tomorrow, Outcast. Not me.
Oh, are you gonna shut your mouth? Because that would be a surprise.
Nice job handling Bost. That should keep him quiet. Till morning, anyway.
I don't believe we've met. I'm Aloy.
Oh, I know who you are. The competition. The others, they'll finish the proving. Most of them. But win it? That's down to Bost, you, or me. Vala.
Nice to meet you, Vala. You're right. I am going to win tomorrow.
Never celebrate a victory before it's earned, girl. My mother taught me that. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna get some sleep. I plan to be well-rested when I run you into the ground tomorrow. Your bunk's right there when you want it.
Okay. Thanks.
Bost won't leave her alone.
I'm here for the proving. That's it. Leave me alone.
So, your first day in Mother's heart. What do you think? You've never slept in a Nora lodge before. Not very private.
It's loud, and it stinks, and the people are... idiots. All these people who kept me out. And now here I am, stuck inside with them.
I think you'll find more to like in the days ahead. Get some rest.